ITV.
Go.
See, bring that your camera, that your phone down.
Hey, your phone.
As you're aware, it was
I insisted to find out from the institution why it was not the court, which I made a report to the court. But we understand the position of the court starts today. So that may, that apparently is the reason why we are not involved. So that is today. So the court said we need to hear from TJ to enable him to proceed during this vacation. So that has been resolved. So we are going to initiate a communication to CJ to ensure that Fiat is going to worship to continue to try during this vacation. So as we are aware, I've mentioned it upstairs, Nnamdi Kanu, before 2021, we have Nnamdi Kanu 2015, who was abducted by DSSM on the 14th of October 2015 in Lagos and brought before Abuja here, brought in Abuja here the 10th. He was taken to Magistrate Court, and which granted him bail, and Cosway brought before this court, Honorable Federal Court, which also granted him bail. And those bail orders granted by the court directing for his own conditional release were all fronted by security agents, by the DSS. So, until we effectively and successfully challenge the 11 count charge preferred against him at the time by the federal government, and then 8 out of them were struck out, remaining 3. So, on the basis of those, of the weakness of the strength of the remaining allegations, the court granted him bail on the 5th of April 2007 and scheduled for the matter for hearing. I got the case to October 17th for hearing, 2017 for hearing. So, why are we waiting for the time for him to be in court on October 17th for the trial to commence? His premises, ancestral home in Omaya, Afaruku Maya, was invaded by the military soldiers on the September 14th, during which blood invasion, over 28 persons were killed in his premises. And he manually escaped by sheer providence, not unhurt, he was inflicted with injuries. So, and we have applications before this court for the court to intervene and also investigate the circumstance that led to his disappearance. An intervening event that occurred that led to him to his inability to be in court and start his trial. So these applications are pending for the past 2 years before this court. Only for us to have up on 29th of June, that he was brought to court. So, and we're ready to go on. So, but the fact is that the Nnamdi Kanu we are talking about today is a person that was abducted in Kenya on June 19th, 2021, then tortured, subjected to all forms of inhuman treatment and degradation, inflicted with grievous bodily harms, which is still in his body today. So before, after spending 8 days, after subjecting to all sorts of torture, then he was handed over to Nigerian security agents 8 days after. So on the 29th, they brought him to court. So what I'm saying is that we are talking about gross violation of Geneva Convention Protocol, which agreement Nigeria entered into in 2001. This is very fundamental because as far as we are concerned today, Nigeria's image in international community has been damaged, has been bastardized by virtue of what has been taking place. We don't go to a foreign land and kidnap somebody. If the person has committed an offense known to law, you subject him through what they call extradition proceedings. Then the person will pass through the extradition proceedings. Instead of smuggling here through what they call extraordinary rendition. But that's a very fundamental issue we're discussing before international court and the international community. Today we have various applications and corresponding to form with the African court, which is being championed by my colleague Zialo Ejimakor, and also our foreign partners in UK and the US.
So as you tell us the specific 3 orders issued by Justice Binta Inapo.
No, today the exhaustive order, first of all, that you need an order from the CJ to proceed with trial. Then 2, that the detention authority, in this case the SSS, should give us access to our client. Because I complain about the way and manner we see him. For the past 8 days, we don't have that, we don't see him. And only yesterday, we had over the social media. As I've been taken away from Abuja, I complained to the court that he has been taken away from here. And we can't confirm his present state of health. So the court has to intervene
and give directive to the detention authority that we should have access to him on specified dates within a week, which I may not mention to you. So, but that has been agreed, and we're going to see him anymore for now. So, and we have an application to get him transferred to Correctional Center Kuje Prison, which was served on the federal government on 17th of July 2021. Only for on the 14th of July, yes, 2021. Only for us to ambush all this money with the accountability to that application. But we don't want to go into the merit because the court is actually not ready to go on with the proceeding today because of the foundation commences today. So on the next adjourned date, we are going to have a bite of that. Thank you so much.
What are you about adjourned date?
Nnamdi Kanu, you must sing in Nnamdi Kanu. Do you have fears? What are your fears?
No, as I speak to you, we are aware that the international community is going on proceedings before this court. And they are aware that Nnamdi Kanu is in detention facility of the ESS. So if anything happened to Nnamdi Kanu today, the federal government, the ESS, and all the authorities concerned should be held responsible by the international community. Because UK, US are in effective communication with our legal team as to what is happening in this case. I can confirm that to you today. As I speak to you now, I don't want to mention the international media organization who are following up this case, who are in this court today to cover what proceedings of the court today. Thank you so much.
Is it true that your name? Your lawyers were arrested?
No, lawyer was arrested.
Okay, well, we are.
What happened?
What's your view on
that? We have a situation whereby lawyers were chastised today, we are brutalized, kind of. We were not allowed inside the court because we are suggesting the system should trim down the number of lawyers. I know this is an international case. This is a case that arose Igbo's interest and interest of right responsible people. So every responsible person wants to know what's happening in this case. So and that has been resolved with the cops.
What of your IPOB members that were arrested this morning? Who came in here? Many of them were arrested.
We are going to confirm that. We are aware many of them. I was just informed in court that many of them were many people that came here were arrested. So and I'm urging the authority. I am urging the authority by this video to release those who were in court to witness proceedings of today. They were not violent. There were many here to witness proceedings of the court. And it's your constitutional right to be in court and witness proceedings of the court. If you are limiting, if you have a restriction to the number of people that will come to the court, we have no problem. But you can't that not warrant to arresting them. Innocent and defensive.
There's no order for civil trial.
It was not because the trial hasn't commenced and there's no order for civil trial yet. There's no order for civil trial. And I wish we are going to pretend if there's any order of such session. Thank you so much.
Your name, sir.
My name is Ifeanyi Ejiofor. I'm lead counsel to Nnamdi Kanu.
And I'm here. Okay, wait. Go.